every new sentence. Every new sentence is a opportunity to be distracted by the rushing river of thought. Every video that we watch, every action and every word on the video is an opportunity to be distracted by the rushing river of thought. And by the rushing river of involuntary, automatic attention, locked inside the rushing river of thought. And so it takes a special practice of purposely entering into a state of ignoring that slip into the river of rushing waters. For everything that comes my way, all distractions. Right now, my greatest distractions are YouTube videos. But as I practice more and more of keeping my attention in this present moment, looking at the walls around me, this keeps me grounded in the reality of eternity. Spending time with Mother Nature. Although these are manufactured walls of Mother Nature, it's the closest thing to her real self, which is being out in the backyard amongst all the live, living creations. So, I'm going to turn on the other monitor, and I'm going to slide the video over to the other side. And since how I've been watching a lot of cam girls here lately, last night and this morning, I noticed that the universe has sent me a picture of a penis grow increasement advertisement. It just came out of nowhere. And in fact, many of them just popped up on the screen. And it says this: why is the adult industry doomed? How an angry ex-porn star reveals one amazing trick that average guys use to get hung. Watch video to get a bigger dick. And there's a picture of this guy who has a dick the size of his forearm and just as thick hanging down with a set of nuts the size of half of his fist. So as I say these things, I notice that there is a tendency to want to be distracted into the rushing river of thoughts, but I am purposely keeping myself attentive. There is a tendency for my thoughts to want to, or for my brain to want to sink into the rushing rivers of doubt and unbelief as to my expectations, to my desires that I am moment by moment expecting for my uplifting and well-being and confirmation of who I am and what I've accomplished and what I am expecting to accomplish, such as ATM access to that U.S. Treasury Trust account. I have learned that with every new video, with every new web page, with every message on the web page, it is an opportunity for distraction. And that distraction is recognized as the power of suggestion, which is just a test of Mother Nature. Now, in the background, I just had a thought pass by for 2 seconds, and I noticed that my eyes became unattentive to my surroundings for 2 seconds. But the thought said, now the neighbor has just started his car, and I've noticed that the neighbor always starts his car when I have sexual thoughts. I have noticed this pattern over and over again. So I'm listening to the neighbor, keyed into the sound of his truck, and he is driving out of the driveway to drive down the rock road and down to the city street. This has happened so many times over and over again that this tells me that it holds significant meaning in the conversation of Mother Nature. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 advertisements that popped up behind my screen, and there are pictures of guys that have huge dongs that are just hanging. Why the porn industry is doomed? Well, this brings me to the present moment, maintaining my thoughts my attention, not my thoughts, but my attention on the walls around me, the cats that are here, not getting lost in the thought, of the rushing river, the thoughts of worry, doubt, and unbelief. And the rest of the message goes like this. A disgraced 28-year-old ex-porn star reveals an amazing trick that lets average guys get a massive cock fast. It works so insanely well. Now as I read that, I'm monitoring my attention to stay on the walls around me, to fix myself to be grounded, listening to the dog that just barked because the back door is open, and also to become unattached. Just because I started reading an advertisement doesn't mean I have to finish reading it. And I'm well aware that when I've started reading advertisements before, that my mind would get lost in the rapids of thought, the rushing rapids of thought, and want to bring all kinds of anxiety into the direction of the river. But not no more this moment, as I stay grounded. So I'll just click this one off. Why is the porn industry doomed? Now, with the power of suggestion, our thoughts could rise and become, overtake our attention on our walls that we're looking at, and this would create our reality. But when I see why the porn art industry is doomed, all I see is just words on a page that the Russian rivers of thoughts would like to define all kinds of different ways. But if I refuse myself to get lost in the rushing rivers of thought, which for the most part, all's that the rushing river of thought wants to do is define everything and put it in the category of right and wrong. But as I was masturbating to the cam girls last night and this morning, I was staying in the present moment, and I was holding back my seed. But my member genital was throbbed to its fullest capacity for hours upon end at the virtual point of orgasm, but with my attention, I kept myself just at the brink of the orgasm, and I did not orgasm at all. Although some fluid did leak out a little here and there. And so I remember having one thought that was in the background as I was masturbating. And that was this. It was the thought of a penis pump. That my genital was in the natural condition of a self penis pump. Because I have withheld my seed for the past month. And that makes the genital have a very light effort to maintain its full power of readiness to orgasm. Most of us know this as the longer you wait, the easier it is and the quicker it is for the orgasm to happen. But, like I said, I just maintained the precipice of orgasm and did not orgasm. And my genital stayed at the full engorged throbbing level, just like it would a penis pump for. And it stayed like that for hours at a time. So, as I read and I see that the universe is attracting now the pictures of these engorged penises that have been pumped up to massive size. But in the back of my mind, I think to myself, just remain in the moment. And let things just be as they are. All things will naturally happen that need to happen according to the desires that we have. And we don't have to hang on tightly to our desires. And we do not have to hang on tightly to any suggestive powers that advertisements might have on us. But yet at the same time realizing that Mother Nature brings all these advertisements to us to test us, to see if we are going to maintain our focus on her or if we are going to jump into the rushing rivers of thought and get washed away in imbalance. If we stay balanced by purposely keeping our attention on our surroundings, then this is the key to maintaining balance with our thoughts. Our thoughts are held at bay, just like I held my penis at bay from orgasm. Very interesting. So as I scroll from advertisement to advertisement of these pop-ups, I have a picture of a penis that shows all the veins in it. Very interesting. Shows how all the blood travels in the veins. And the advertisement says this will haunt the adult industry forever. Now, that's just a test for Mother Nature to see what direction we want to take our thoughts. Do we want to hold on to the words of the advertisement suggestion and say to ourselves, huh, the advertisement is true. This will haunt the adult industry forever. Or do we just see it as a test of Mother Nature to see whether or not we will just observe it as it passes by and add no definition to it? And just maintain our attention on the now present moment, everything surrounding around us, which is a full sensation of peace and safety. Full satisfaction. So I just clicked off all the ads, all the pop-up ads. There was about 5 pages worth. I just had a light thought in the background say, the video's been going for enough. Click it off. Start another one. There's a motorcycle in my ears to keep myself centered in the present moment. To click the video off and to start another one is indicative of a sense of rushing, of haste. So I think I will just keep my attention fixed to the present moment and just keep that thought as an observation and just be here in the moment. And the moment will reveal itself of what to do step by step without having to put any thought into it. I've experienced this before where I'd be in the backyard and I would focus on cleaning up the shed, or focus on observing everything in the yard on a nice summer day that I could do. All kinds of projects I could start. And as I'd walk through the yard, my attention would be centered and grounded until finally it would zero in on something that would fill the capacity of my spiritual boner. And it would be engorged with blood at full throb. And I would begin all of a sudden doing a particular action, such as cleaning out the shed. And I would start naturally, slowly. But my experience has shown me that once I start a project, I usually end up getting lost in thought and moving way too fast, lifting things at odd angles and tearing my lower back all to shreds. And my root chakra would be inflamed massively. And this is what's called self-injury. Of which I need to eliminate. I need to learn to love myself. I need to learn to slow down. Because as I go, so goes the rest of the world. As I keep my attention focused on my surroundings, I am now aware of it at a deeper level, that all brains are connected in one. I am floating through the whole earth, around the earth, all the stars, all the universe, we are one. Although I'm in this room right now with the four walls, in my imagination I can see the stars outside, because it is a clear day today, and the stars are shining brightly on this February Indian summer that we're having.